We've got Phil Lynott back with us again. Phil, thanks for coming back. One thing that unites both of you fellas, that in an age of rouge, mascara,
we had
and
the
skirts,
same
and I'm talking about
we're united because we have the same mother. We're not brothers, just the same.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah. What a remarkable genetic fact.
Yeah, right.
We're indebted to you for that. But anyway, in an age when it's all rouge, mascara, and maybe slightly small voices, you guys deliver. Why do you think you came to prominence with basically a voice that wasn't part of its time?
Why do I think I
can? I mean, in other words, do you not feel sometimes that you're a late 60s sound in terms of the way you deliver?
I feel more in tune with the 50s. And I always say, I think I was born too late. You know, that's how I feel a lot of the times. Yeah. You know, it's like, because the old stuff, it's like when we go on stage, you know, sometimes we like, I put in like an old song each tour, a different old song. And those are always the ones that, you know, it's like they seem very natural. I mean, things like the new stuff that we're doing, some of this stuff, Mad on the Hell, is very natural, but I have a more empathy with the 50s stuff instead of the 60s. That's it. 60s was a bit psychedelic. And
we can talk
always talking about greenhouses in purple fields with red trees above marshmallow moons, you know, and that didn't... they don't fit with me, and I don't understand that.
Listen, this record, Ballad of Hell, we mentioned, this was a phenomenon. We can talk forever about your voice, but why don't we hear it? Let's go one better.
Oh.
Your latest record is Modern Girl, and it really is a belter.
Ah.
Let's have a look at that. And
wonderful
once again,
song.
The old bikes are in prominence.
Oh, yeah,
aren't
oh, yeah, the bikes.
Great.
Don't cut now,
we had to.
Oh, that's too bad.
Well, we'll cut it there because we'll show it again some other
oh,
way.
Oh, good.
The whole thing. But that, as I say, was a real belter. But do you mind me saying that was a message song, isn't it? Femlib, that must be the Femlib anthem there, isn't it?
Well, it sort of is. A girl named Sarah Durkee actually wrote the lyrics, so probably that's what she had in mind. But when I don't think of it, I just think of it as a total lib song. Because, I mean... To me, it's like, it's sort of, this is a weird representation, but who says that you have to wear white when you play tennis? I mean, that's the kind of, that's my
sure.
attitude, you know? And it is, I mean, and the video, I really like it because we use like real girls. I mean, you know, as opposed to, not to put down models or anything, but I think models have been overplayed in videos. In other words, you know,
yeah.
Women are being used in videos, you know, with the lingerie. Ah!
So, well, funny you should mention
that. Yeah, lingerie. You know, I'm going to get off that. But anyway, you know, and with no point. I mean, just laying on a bed, turning around, and I just found that, you know, a bit awkward. And Brian Grant, who directed this, is fabulous, a well-known video director. And I just let him go on this one. And it's like the shot that you just had there. I went to this little girl, I'm going to say. She was little, but she's not a young girl. But she's a real motorcycle racer. And she's like a real human being, a real person.
Right.
And people objected to me going to her in the video and putting my arm around her. I said, absolutely not. That's a real person I'm putting my arm around. And that's made me feel good about that.
We've got another great deliverer here, Phil Lynott. And there's one thing that unites you two guys. You both nearly lost something. You nearly lost your hearing, did you not, Phil?
Yeah, nearly lost a few things in my time, you know.
But tell us about it. I mean, quite seriously.
Well, at one stage, we were doing about 50 dates on the trot, and we were playing in America. And in America, the venues are much bigger, so you use a lot more amplification.
Yeah.
And I made the mistake of standing in front of the lead guitar player's amplifier for a little too long.
And you didn't hear a word.
So that night I heard ringing in my ears. So I thought it was serious. So I got a doctor around. And of course, doctors, they're very conscientious and they always play safe. And they went, if I were you, I wouldn't do that again, which I'd learned the lesson by then.
Well, to lose your hearing is pretty crucial, isn't it? But to lose your voice, which you did.
Well, I did that by standing in front of my own monitors for too long, I think, you know. I didn't lose my voice. And I'll tell you what happened was, after Bad, I mean, I've been in rock and roll bands and theater and different things since 1966, so, but I never dealt with something that became a multi-million dollar business, and it was sort of an awakening for me, you know. I mean, I have the foundation and all that, and it wasn't like overnight, but it was a real awakening to see. My thing is now to see the snakes in the grass, and they were poisonous, and it was sort of, I didn't like that. I mean, I liked it. I wanted to make records and tour, and I never thought of anything else other than just doing that. And when it was over, I sort of rebelled.
Yeah.
And the only way for me to rebel so that I didn't have to do anything, I think, was just say, I can't sing. And so I convinced myself I couldn't. Mm-hmm. And I just sort of like dropped out, you know. It's like a rock and roll dropout.
And there's certain singers as well who have very delicate voices who if they do a lot of sort of engagements, their voice will go, and they need a long while for it to recover. And some people, if they push it too hard, if they keep, it can do permanent damage.
Yes,
but, I mean, Meatloaf has a voice like my own, that the harshness is half the texture.
Sort of. If it is when you get on the road, it is the texture.
Well, grateful for it. Meat, I think you've lost weight. In fact, you look like a slice of salami. Do you like good cliches? Because after the break, you're going to be in Rusty's kitchen.
I know all about Rusty. I heard all about
That'll
Rusty.
Solve your weight problem.
I'm dying to go see Rusty. Rusty!
Who needs advertising? Let's take a break.